My little and cute learners, I'm Rashmi, your English teacher, and I'm back again with yet another interesting video on chapter number 2 of your literature book. And the name of the chapter is Ivan's Story. This story is about Ivan, the gorilla, and how he adapts himself in human society. Adapts means adjusts. This chapter is originally taken from a novel named One and Only Ivan. The book is inspired by the true story of Ivan the gorilla, who spent 27 years living in a human home or at a mall. I want all of you to know that this story is written by an American writer named Catherine Applegate. Who is the writer? Catherine Applegate. It's a very sensitive story about the feelings that the animals have. Children, do you like keeping pets? I'm sure you love them. And I want all of you to take good care of them. Alright? I would love to hear your feelings about your pets once the school reopens. Let's start the story now.
Ivan was an easygoing and fun-loving silverback gorilla who spent his initial years in a dense rainforest in Central Africa with his parents and twin sister named Tag. Ivan, along with his sister, used to play until his father gave them a grunt. Wait, let me show what is a grunt. So that was a grunt. Are you scared? No, don't be. It's just a story. Anyhow, the young gorilla used to draw pictures on rocks and barks with mud. That's why his parents started calling him Mud. They were 10 in number, and Mud and Tag were the young ones. Mud compares that somehow the life of a gorilla baby, an elephant baby, and a human baby is not so different, except that a gorilla gets to spend the whole day riding on his mother's back. As they grew, they started learning the skills and habits of the gorillas. And then the day comes when a couple, Mac and his wife Helen, took him to their home in a crate. Crate means a large wooden container for transporting things. They raised the young gorilla like a human baby, like how and where to sit, to sleep and drink. Sometimes Helen got angry for Mud's mischiefs, especially when he broke anything, which he usually did. On weekends, Mac and Helen used to take him to restaurants, grocery stores, movie theaters and so on. Although the young gorilla was well taken care of, but still he missed something. And what was that? That was his forest life. The grunts of a play fight with his sister, with his parents, and his free life there in the forest. And that's how the story ends.
So this was chapter number 2. Did you like the video? If yes, do share your feedback with me in the communication section on the portal. We will meet soon. Till then, take care of yourselves and study well.